Hi there, welcome back to another episode of Nature Aquariums TV, where today we're going to break down the setup and unboxing of Oase's Biomaster series of filters and its accessories. Before we get with our video, please remember to like, share, and subscribe for more videos like this. Today, we're super excited to go over a very detailed and thorough explanation on how to set up your Oase Biomaster series filters, the associated accessories that are available with it, and how you can set it up. And I'm going to show you some of my personal best secrets and tips and tricks that are going to save you a lot of time, and it's going to make your installation a breeze. You have the Biomaster canister filter. Each filter number comes in two variations. One is called the thermo, one's called the regular. The difference between the two is that the thermo already comes with a heater already in the box. Now, all of the Biomaster canister filters, you can retrofit the heater in them if you didn't buy one with the heater. Inside the box already comes with the adapter ring, and that you can add the heater in there. Two, I wanted to cover something that most people don't know that Oase makes, and which are the shutoff valves. And they make them so they're compatible with all of the filters that they make. Lastly, I wanted to cover the ClearTronic clarifier that they have. Now, this is a UV clarifier. It's meant to help with the clarity of your tank, and it's plumbed in line with any of your Biomaster filters, or actually FiltoSmart canister filters as well. It works very well. We're gonna unbox it, show you the couple of tips and tricks on it, and we're going to show you one in action and how well it works. First part over here, and I'm pointing this so it makes it easier for you to find. Here is the canister filter. Let's put this to the side, and you get a secondary box with all of your accessories. In the box with every one of the Biomaster filters, you're going to get the following. You're going to get the tubing. All of the Biomaster tubing is 5/8 tubing, or 16/22 millimeter size tubing. Also, you're gonna get the adapter for your heater. You're gonna get the rain bar, spray bar, and the intake. Instructions, nice colored instructions. Inside the bag over here, I wanted to go over some specialized hardware here. I know this may look like a bag of Legos, but trust me, it isn't. One of the things you're gonna find is you're gonna see these blue nuts over here. And the way they work, they're there to tighten up the tubing. When you slip your tubing on, you should really tighten these up so they go all the way up. As you slide on your tubing, hold both of them and start undoing the blue nut until it forms a nice tight suction against the vinyl tubing. It's a little bit counterintuitive, guys, because normally you're used to tightening something to make it tighter, it actually loosens it up. Untightening it actually tightens it against the hose. That's the way the majority of these canister filters are set up. So it's a little bit counterintuitive, but keep that in mind. Two, the inflows and outflows are identical, so they're interchangeable, and they do have flow control. You can use a penny, a coin, or a flathead screwdriver, and you can close and open the flow of the tank. Lastly, it does come with the suction cups to hold it. And if you don't use the spray bar, you have the outflow nozzle. It's directional, so when you set this over the rim of your tank, you can actually adjust this to the side or up if you actually want to ripple your water and oxygenate. So it's very important that you don't lose these pieces. You're also going to use where the tubing attaches to the canister filter, and they work the same way. This pretty much covers what you get in there. I want to talk about the tubing for a minute, and I'm going to give you a trick that works really, really well every time you install this. I would suggest grabbing the largest pot, cooking pot, right, that you use to cook pasta or potatoes, and fill it with water. Curl this so the whole piece of tubing can actually fit inside the pot, and bring the water to almost a boil. You don't want it boiling. You want to get it to about 190 degrees, basically to the point that you see a couple bubbles forming at the bottom of the pot. At that point, pull it away from the heat, and the tubing is going to come out very, very soft. It's important to do that because you want to eliminate the muscle, the memory that the tubing has, right? So when you get it out, it's going to be very, very limp. It's going to be like wet spaghetti, and it's going to allow you to do two things. The ends are going to be very soft. It is super important that when this is soft, it expands the tubing. It'll allow you to slip this over the barb fitting here. As the tubing cools off, it'll shrink and it'll create a nice airtight seal around the pipe. That is critical to avoid any airflow or rattling or noise in filters. From speaking to a lot of customers and answering a lot of questions, even with any brand, whether it's an Oase filter or any brand that you do, always follow that, because that's always going to reduce the noise in the tank. It's going to reduce the amount of air being sucked into the canister filter and causing those microbubbles. The next part I want to talk about is the order and how you should set this up. You set up a canister filter under your aquarium stand or on the floor. One of the things that they do over here, these ends actually swivel, so we can adjust it to wherever we want to set up this canister filter. So if you're having, if you're the end of the tank is here, you can actually rotate these and they're labeled in and out. Start first by assembling your tubing. Say if this is your spray bar, you hang this on your tank with the tubing very hot and very flexible. Start from the top. Let the tubing, now it's going to hang very easily. It's going to be very soft and very easy to work with. Now remember, you don't have a whole lot of time to work with this, and I will tell you, wear gloves if your hands are sensitive to heat, because the tubing's going to be extremely hot. In addition, when the filter is first set up, you will have to do a move called burping your filter, and that's while it's running, rocking it to the left, to the right, front and back, and that's usually to get rid of any air bubbles or any air that's trapped. If your tubing is way too tight, you're not going to be able to do that. So leave yourself about 8 to 10 inches of slack. So this is already hanging up from the side of your tank. You're gonna cut it and then you're gonna make your connection. The next part I wanna cover is the heater port. So if you get a regular Biomaster filter, in the box, you're gonna get one of these caps that have a hole. You're gonna say, well, a hole does me no good. Well, this is specifically for the heat up line of heaters from Oase, and you'll get this cap over here. You really don't have to do anything with this cap if you're not going to use the heater. Leave it in there. To take it off, it's just a simple quarter of a turn twist. If your model is the Biomaster Thermo, then this will be in the box, and in its place will be this unit along with the heater already pre-installed. If you bought a regular Biomaster and then later on you want to add a heater, then it's very simple. Check out with Oase on the side of the box. You will get a chart telling you what is the right heater for the Biomaster tank that you, Biomaster canister filter that you have for your tank. You cannot put a larger heater than was designed for the canister filter, and that's due to the length of the heater. The nice thing about having it here is it allows the temperature control to be visible, so you'll always have access to a nice clean heater and you can see what temperature you have it set at. Next part that I want to cover. So Oase decided to make their canister filters in this really nice contemporary gray, and they use blue on all the items that are either levers or user adjustable sections. So let's cover what that means. Up front here, you see there's two levers. This one is what prevents, that locks out the water from draining onto the floor. So when you slide this lever here, it allows you to disconnect your tubing connected to your tank with the inflow and outflow. This also shuts off a valve over here, so it prevents your tank from being drained. So if you ever need to do any work on the canister filter, you unplug the filter to make sure it's not running. The next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna slide this to unlock. When it does unlock, it shuts off the water flow, no risk of flooding your home. The second part that we're gonna do is once you hit unlock here, you shut off the water flow, it allows us to release the pre-filter. Now, this is what makes an Oase canister filter best in its class. All of the water that goes before goes into the trays goes through these pre-filter sponges. And what this does, it traps all of the dirt, leaves, uneaten food, all the debris goes through in here before eventually passes from the outside to the inside, and the inside then flows into the trays. This is what's doing all the work of cleaning and pre-cleaning your filter. This big round button, this is your primer. So when you set this filter up in your aquarium, brand new, it is bone dry, empty. You've now made your connections, everything's set to go. Before you plug in the filter, push on the primer and you'll actually feel there's very strong suction onto the inflow side, and it's going to start siphoning the water and fill this whole thing with water so the motor can do its job. The way this works, you got to pay attention, push the siphon, it'll start filling it up. When you stop hearing the sound of water flowing into the canister filter and there's no more air bubbles coming out of the outflow, then you can plug in the filter and it's going to start cycling the water. The next part that's going to be in blue are going to be the disconnects to remove the head from the body of the canister filter. This filter has a really nice, comfortable handle that's meant for you to lift it, take it to do cleaning and maintenance. These are open like this, but the sides will not open unless you raise the handle. And that's done as a safety, because then it allows you to open it up this way. One thing I will tell you, if there was a heater, your heater would be attached over here and it would be extended here. So let's show you what you've got going on in here. Depending on the model, the higher the model number, the more trays you're gonna have. The last tray is this polishing sponge. So on a 250, you're gonna get one tray of media, two blue sponges, and one orange sponge. As your model number goes up, you end up getting additional trays. In a larger motor are the differences between the 250 all the way to the 850. Now, a lot of people have commented and talked about why is the biological media at the bottom, should be on the top. I wanted to explain that the flow of this filter is as follows. When water flows in, it first flows in through the pre-filter, which is this here. This is what cleans the water before it flows through the bottom first. The bottom is where your biological media needs to be. The bottom of the canister filter was designed to work with their helix media, which you need to remove out of this bag. They put it in a bag for shipping, but ideally you should cut this, pour it in there. So this is fluidized media. This is supposed to be suspended and moving around, doing its best job to reduce ammonia. And then lastly, always leave this last sponge over here. This sponge also serves the purpose of breaking up any excess air bubbles that you may have and give you a nice stream of water. So before I put this head on, I actually want to show you what the other maintenance on this filter is, and this is something that you probably need to do every 2 months. So this is the pump head. This is where the motor is that circulates the water. There is a cleaning procedure that you need to do this to clean the filter, and to do that you need to remove the impeller. You rotate this, pull it out, and this is the impeller, guys. What's nice, Oase uses a stainless steel shaft for longevity. I've worked with a lot of companies that sometimes they use ceramic, and the ceramic are nice, but they do break. And there's nothing worse than doing maintenance at 9 o'clock at night on a Saturday night, and you break the impeller, and now you have no filtration over a whole weekend, and you have to order it and maybe wait for that. So Oase definitely scores really well with their stainless steel shaft. Once you are done, you push that in. On the cover over here, there is actually one side that is notched. That's so this will fit like that. So the notch side always goes towards the center of the pump head. Push that down, snaps into place. That snaps into place, and this is the cover. That's all the maintenance, guys, that you have to do on that pump head. Before we finish, we're gonna make sure that we align this hole over here, that's your heater hole. You line it up with the heater cap. These pump heads should sit in perfectly straight. They should not be uneven. The gap should be the same front to back. And I always like going in opposite pairs for the latches at the same time. That's it. That's sealed. It's that easy. We're gonna put the pre-filter back in here, close that, and the minute you do this, once again, it's gonna take water from your tank and it's gonna start filling this. If for some reason did your maintenance and it's not filling it, all you do is push down on the primer and it's gonna create some suction and it's gonna start bringing the water down into the inlet and filling this with water. Once this is done filled with water, you can plug it in. All right, guys, so you guys may remember this is our 130 discus planted tank, and I wanna show you the equipment that we're running in here so you can replicate this at home. We're running two Oase filters. I'm running a Biomaster 850 thermo with the heater. Now, this is a tank that I need to run at 85 degrees with the Biomaster 850 and a Biomaster 350 thermo. That provides us more than enough heating. Sometimes actually this tank will get up to 86, 87 degrees. More than fine for the discus. They actually love it being nice and toasty. In addition, we have the ClearTronic UV Clarifier in there, and we're gonna add the shutoff valves, so it's gonna allow me to do bulb replacements a little bit easier by not having to worry about water flowing and draining. What I do wanna show you is how easy the maintenance is on these Biomaster filters, and I'm gonna show you two parts. One, the pre-filter, that in under 3 minutes, you can clean it and put it back into your canister filter. You do that once a week. And I'm gonna show you the breakdown of how to clean the actual canister filter. I haven't done that in a couple of weeks, so I think right now it'd be really good and you'll be able to follow me from home and watch how that is done. First thing you wanna do is shut off power to the filter. You're gonna shut the water supply to the canister filter. I'm gonna tell you this, always take a rag, place it on top of the pre-filter, because as you disconnect, it always wants to burp a little bit of water, and have a pail or a little bucket to raise this so you don't drip. And now follow me to the laundry room. We first cut this open like this. Look at all that beautiful dirt. A lot of you may be saying, why am I using tap water? This area here, even though it has good bacteria, but you have so many other places in the canister filter that you can house beneficial bacteria that I'd rather get a good clean and get rid of all this mulm and dirt than to not clean it. Now all you do is slide these on. Before I put this on, I like to put a drop of prime or any dechlorinator. Like that, slides on like that, and we are ready to install it. All right, before putting it in, just remember the wide notch goes on the inside in the middle of the tank. The little notch goes on the outside. Put it in like that, close that, and close that. That'll start the process of filling this back up with water. And in about a minute, you can turn on the power and you're ready to go. All right, guys, so I told you that we had gone and done extensive maintenance on this tank. So the filters actually be really, really dirty. We need to clean that out. And I wanna show you how you would do maintenance on the Oase Biomaster filters. This applies to all of their models, the 250 through the 850. Doesn't matter whether it's the heated or non-heated version. So the first things we're gonna do is make sure the power is off, unplug it. And then if you have the heater version, we wanna also go and unplug heater. So now we have the two plugs. We need to disconnect where it goes to unlock. And now you kind of slowly rock it back and forth. And now you move the tubing out of the way. Use the handle, and you can pick up and carry your canister filter. Very nice handle, easy to carry. So let's go back and clean this. So we're ready to take this filter apart. On this particular filter, we already cleaned the pre-filter, so we don't have to worry about cleaning it. I'm gonna put it to the side, and now we're gonna separate the pump head from the rest of the filter. The top plate is just that, a lot of sponge. From the top, I have another sponge. In this particular filter, I have some Ciprax polishing filter pads, and I have Purigen. As you can see, this has turned completely brown. It is time to replace this. Now, in another video, I'll talk about how you can recharge Purigen. These guys I've been using, these are Ciprax Clear. They're fiberglass, but I've been using a lot of them. It's time to chuck them out and get new ones. And after that, I have some Matrix media and more Matrix. This was from a filter I had migrated to, so that's why you don't see any of the Helix media from Oase. On the 850 next to it, it is full of the Helix media from Oase. At home, you may not have RODI in this quantity. Once again, use dechlorinated tap water. You do not want to run straight tap water out of the tap. Now you see there's a lot of debris in there. We want to clean that out. And I'm going to start with my bottom basket, matching up this . Make sure that fits in nicely. These are the sponges. We're gonna go and clean them with dechlorinated tap water. This is gonna be our last basket, and this is gonna be for our chemical media. I already have some fresh Purigen ready to go. I'm gonna rinse it with dechlorinated water. Set it like that, and we're going to put some of our polishing pads. So that's nice and solid. It's not rocking. That's it in firmly. We're going to put our heater. Heater is installed, and our pre-filter locked and loaded. Let's go and get this into the cabinet. We're going to put this back in here. You do not put in the power to either the heater or the filter at this moment. The first thing you want to do is put your tubing back in, open that up, and it should start already pre-filling. If it isn't, now it's going to start taking in some of the water. Once the bubbling has stopped in the filter, go ahead, turn it on, and water should start coming out of the filter, and now you can plug in your heater. All right, guys, and just like that, you've done a full cleaning of your Oase Biomaster filter. Once again, this applies to models 250 through 850. As you can see, it did not take very long. If you continue maintaining your pre-filter maintenance once a week, you should be able to get by doing the main filter cleanup only every 3 to 6 weeks, depending on your bio load. I hope you saw how easy it is to set up a Biomaster and how easy it is to maintain and clean a Biomaster filter. Now, we've been using these for almost 2 years at our aquariums here at the store. We've had countless of customers tell us how great they are and how happy they are. I hope you will get a chance to experience one of these filters. Make sure you use the comment section, leave us comments, any questions you may have, and we really appreciate your support, guys. Remember to keep your tanks clean and have a great day fish keeping.